Okay, here we're going to take a look at a marginal analysis problem, which is where we're trying to figure out how the revenue or cost or profit change as the production level changes as we make more items. It could be toaster ovens or tennis shoes, or it doesn't matter what it is. Marginal analysis is just trying to figure out what's happening to the revenue or profit or cost as there's changes in production levels. So here we go. This one just happens to be marginal revenue for this exercise, but this function here is going to give us the monthly revenue from selling X number of items. Oftentimes, the revenue that you bring in, or the cost that you spend, or the profits that you bring in, depend on how many items you're producing or selling. Sometimes, you know, I think of an example like t-shirts. You know, if you have custom t-shirts made, and you only buy 5 of them, you're probably going to spend quite a lot because of like the setup cost. But if you bought 1,000 copies of that, you know, custom t-shirt, you would get it for a lot cheaper because the cost is depending on how many t-shirts that they're producing or making for you. So you see how that could fluctuate depending on how many items you produce or sell. All right. So anyway, if you tell me the number of items we've sold, then this will be the total revenue for selling that many items. So we would expect this function to go up because obviously if you sell more, you make more. All right, now, I'll come back to this picture in a minute. This picture will be important here coming up shortly, but let's get right to the typical questions. Normally, these problems will have some business. I didn't give my business a name, but usually I have some made-up business, and they'll be selling some made-up object. And usually these problems will have like a part A, B, and a C, and sometimes D. They're multi-part problems. Well, they'll just ask you different questions. So here's a very typical part A. What's the revenue if you sell 28 items? This is a pretty easy question. If this is the revenue function from selling X number of items, very simply, we would just be plugging 28 into the revenue function. So we'll take R of 28, plug it in, and we'll get an answer. All right, and here I got out my calculator here, and just to save us a little bit of time, I went ahead and typed everything in, and I got $3,967.71. $67.71 there. Okay. Now, is that how much each item costs? No, that's not the cost of each item. That's the cost of, the revenue, excuse me, the revenue of selling all 28 items. Okay, here's a part B. Now we're getting into the change in revenue. Here we go. What's the change in revenue if the sales increase from 28 items sold up to 30 items sold? Well, we know the revenue of selling 28 items was $3,967.71. To get this change in revenue, we would also need the revenue if we sold 30 items, which we'll find in just a second. But really, this answer is not that quantity. It would actually be the revenue for selling all 30 items minus the revenue of selling just the 28 items. And that will give you the difference. That's the change, or the actual change in revenue. So we'll do those real quickly. All right, so if on your TI, if you push second enter, it'll actually bring back the same old equation. And so you can just go through and change out the numbers from 28 to 30 and not actually have to retype everything. Now you can probably do this quicker than I can, being that I'm doing this on the computer. All right, but give me just a second. So I took out those 28s and substitute 30 in its place. Okay, and I got 4,242. So 4,242. Obviously, our revenue is higher. Our revenue is higher if we're selling more items. Now, to get that difference, that change in revenue, we'll take that number and subtract away the $3,967.71. Okay, so that's the change in revenue, $274.29. $274.29. Okay. Now, one thing I'll say before we continue is notice a lot of these require no calculus. Notice we haven't taken a derivative. We haven't done anything other than just basic algebra and basic plug and chug. All right, now here comes the calculus questions. Now, if you have not already watched my video on marginal analysis, marginal cost, marginal profit, marginal revenue, I'd encourage you to watch that before doing part C, because otherwise it probably won't make a lot of sense. All right, we want to know the marginal revenue if we sell 28 items. Now, quick reminder, this is not going to be a thorough discussion, but what is marginal revenue? Well, here's where the graph comes in. If you go up here and this is 28 items sold, what the marginal revenue is going to look at is it's going to be the derivative of the revenue function with respect to x, which will give you the slope of the yellow line, and that'll be the change in revenue per change in items sold. So if you sell 29 items, then that's what R prime is going to tell you, because this is going to be basically the rise in revenue over a run of one item. So hopefully that makes sense there. So that marginal revenue is determined by taking the derivative of the revenue function, and then we'll plug in 28. So if the revenue is, where is it? Somewhere around here. Here we go. 0.006x cubed minus 0.05x squared plus 151x. Do a little algebra. You get 0.018x squared, if you bring the 3 down, minus 1x plus 151, just using basic derivative rules here. So let me see if I can remember all that. R prime marginal revenue will be 0.018x squared minus 1x plus 151. I will take 28 and pop it into that. And we'll get, let's see here, 0.018 times x squared minus 28 plus 151. Okay, we'll get a total of $137.11. Now, this is important. What is $137.11? Well, another way you can write R prime is dr dx. Now, what does that imply in English? This is the change in revenue over the change in quantity sold. So basically rise over run. And this number here, any number, if you were to express it as a fraction, could be written as that number over 1. So this is a change of revenue of $137.11 per 1 unit sold, or 1 extra unit sold. So that goes back to that graph here. So we're rising whatever it was, $137.11 as we sell one more item. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. That's the marginal revenue. All right, now let's try to estimate here what the revenue would be if we sold 29 items. Well, this quantity that we just found was very loosely the extra cost of the 29th item. So I think what we could do is we could take R of 28, we could take the total revenue of making the first 28 items, and then add in that $137.11, right? Because that was the extra for the extra item. So if we go to our calculator here, the first number was the $3,967.71. That's R of 28. And then we will tack on the $137.11 for a total revenue of $4,104.82. $4,104.82. $1.82. And that should be the total revenue, or approximately the total revenue of selling 29 items. Now, these marginals are great. They really help us out because that helped us avoid taking 29 and plugging it in the original ugly revenue function. Now, just for the heck of it, now that we're done, let's just for the heck of it, let's take 29 and see how close this is. And you'll find that using marginals will get you very, very closely, very, very close to the actual revenue for selling 29 items. Let's try it. 0.006 times 29 cubed minus 0.5 times 29 squared plus 151 times 29, and we get $4,104.83. So the actual would be $4,104.83. We were only off by a penny. That's fantastic. Now, in case you're curious, where's this error even coming in? Well, here, it goes back to this tangent line idea. See, the actual change in cost, if you look just on the orange graph, not on the tangent line, this is the actual cost of the 29th item sold. This is an approximation of the cost of the 29th item. Now, a very good question you might have as a student is, Devin, why are we even doing all this stuff? Why don't we just plug in 29? Well, the main reason for this is, one, is computationally ugly. These revenue and cost and profit functions are nasty. And so if we can avoid plugging 28, 29, 27, 30 into the original function as much as possible, we would like to avoid that. See, the whole idea behind marginals is you basically find one, you might call it like a base number, right? Like the revenue at 28, whatever that quantity was. And then using marginals, knowing what the rise or fall is going to be around 28, cost per item, marginal analysis, you can simply add or subtract that easy quantity from your base number. Now, as long as you stay close to 28, you're going to get very, very accurate results, like off by a penny. Now, would this approximation work if you were trying to approximate selling 57 items? No, probably not, because look at the picture here. Do you see how the graph here starts to separate? So as long as you stay local around 28, marginal analysis is fantastic. You just add $137.11 and you get the extra revenue. Or if you subtract $137.11, you get the less revenue for selling maybe like 27 items. If you want to approximate the revenue for 30 items, don't just add $137.11, do that twice, right? Add $137.11 and then another $137.11. And yes, your error will start to grow the more you do that, but it's really, you're talking pennies here, and the benefits outweigh the disadvantages, which would be plugging in 29, 30, 31, 32, back into that really, really nasty original revenue function. So a lot of theory going on here. If you have any questions on anything I did here, please leave me some comments at the bottom of the YouTube video. And one last thing I'll mention before I let you go is that this problem was for marginal revenue, but you would go through the exact same process if it was marginal profits or marginal cost. It's just a different point of emphasis. It's similar functions. They're still dependent on how many items you produce or sell.